Hi, I'm Aiman, and welcome to another video on my Pokémon Go series. This video is gonna detail how to begin Pokémon Go and where to go from there. This video is mainly for those who haven't played Pokémon Go but want to learn about it, or those who Pokémon Go hasn't come out in their country yet, like Malaysia, or Indonesia, or Singapore. So let's get right to it. So when you click on Pokémon Go, it's gonna show the Niantic logo and the Pokémon Go company, the Pokémon company logo. Then it's gonna give you the warning: remember to stay alert at all times, stay aware of all your surroundings. And I've already logged in, but once you do that, we'll get to this screen. So I'm gonna be reading over this text, and let's get to it. Hello there, I am Professor Willow. Did you know that this world is inhabited by creatures known as Pokémon? Pokémon can be found in every corner of the Earth. Some run across the plains, others fly through the skies, some live in the mountains, or in the forest, or near water. I spent my whole life studying them in a regional distribution. Will you help me with my research? That's great, I was just looking for someone like you to help. You'll need to find and collect Pokémon from everywhere. Now, choose your style for your adventure. And then, this is where you customize your character. So you can either choose a boy or a girl. And I'm going to choose a boy, because I'm a boy. So, after the new update, they added way more clothes, too. I'm going to choose my skin color. I'm going to choose a random one, maybe this one. Now you can choose your hair color. You have brown, light, golden, black. I think that's dark brown, maybe? Brown, reddish, blue, and purple? Okay, I guess I'll choose one of these. I'll choose purple. Then your eye color, you have green, you have lighter green, you have hazelnut, I think they call this, dark brown, and blue. I'll choose this one because it kind of looks like gray. Nope. Then you choose your cap. You have 5 options. You have this one, a yellow trim, a red trim, and a blue trim. Obviously, these are supposed to represent the 3 teams: Instinct, Valor, and Mystic. Since I'm Team Mystic, Mystic for the win, I'm gonna choose blue. Now we can choose our shirt color. You have red, orange, yellow, blue slash purple, and wait, that's only 4. So, since they offer different types of shirts, but different colors, they have 2 different variables that are different. So it's kind of hard to choose, especially when you like this style of coloring, but you like maybe this trim. So I'll choose blue. You have, I think, 3 types. You have red trim, orange trim, and orange-reddish trim. So I'll choose light orange trim. Next we have shoes. And let me see how many we have. We have green, 1. White with orange, 2. Yellow, 3. Blue and white, 4. Green and white, 5. Red and white, 6. Yellow and white, 7. And I think that's it. Yeah. We have 7 different shoes to choose. We have 7 different shoes to choose from. So I'm gonna choose maybe the blue and white. And now we have backpacks. So you have 6 choices to choose from. And I'm gonna choose a blue one because this is based off blue. The whole entire thing is based off being blue. So, we're gonna finish that. When you click on the check mark on the bottom, it says, "Are you all set?" Press yes. press no if you're not set and you want to change your customization. You can always change your customization later in the game, so don't worry if you get something wrong during the process. So when you enter Pokémon Go, it gives you one of three warnings. Remember to be alert at all times, stay aware of your surroundings. This is one of them. The other one is don't trespass while playing Pokémon Go. And the other one is don't drive while playing Pokémon Go, if I recall correctly. So now is your choice for a starter Pokémon. He tells you that, oh, there's a Pokemon nearby. Here are some Pokeballs. These will help you catch one. He gives you 50 Pokeballs. And you have the choice from Charmander, Bulbasaur, and Squirtle. But there's a secret Pokemon, which is Pikachu. Pikachu is actually very special to get. Take your iPhone, you need to run away from these Pokemon by walking a far distance enough so that they're out of the circle, and you have to do this four times. Our backyard to our front lawn, it's wide enough so that we can actually do this. So I think I might demonstrate that actually. So might be long, so we'll cut this off. So to amplify the effect and make it a bit faster, we started at the backyard. So the distance from the backyard to the front lawn is about 300 feet or so. So we started at the backyard, and then when we walk all the way to here, then we'll probably get loose of these Pokemon. But we have to do these four times. So if you're really dedicated to Pokemon and you really like Pikachu, I suggest you do this. But if you're not, don't. Let's go. As you can see, we're not even at the street, maybe close. But you can see the circles are kind of out of range. So if we walk a bit more, then you'll see how that they'll change. It should change right about now. So now it teleported. Now they're here on the street. But if you do this three more times, then the Pikachu will appear along with them. It's getting a bit dark, but I'm pretty sure we should be able to fit this in. Okay, so we did this four times, okay? And finally, you can see that Pikachu is now on our screen. So let's catch him as our starter Pokemon. You can use augmented reality to find Pokemon in the real world. I tried to use it, but apparently it doesn't turn on. But anyway, to throw the Pokeball, you gotta slide it. And then release when at the right point in time. And then when the Pokemon gets actually caught by the Pokeball, you gotcha. Pikachu was caught. Then all this new information shows up on the screen, but we're gonna show it in the house. So going back to what we just did to get Pikachu, you need to walk about 100 meters or 400 feet to get the Pokemon to transport to you. But in total, that would be 400 meters or 1600 feet. And because you have to do it four times, and that's a lot of feet, and it's gonna get a lot of exercise, so that's good, right? Just a note, the conversion from meter to feet is 3.3 multiplication, but I just rounded it to an even number. So for those people who say that I'm not good at conversion, it's actually a misconception, okay? But anyway, so once we catch Pikachu, it will be a lot of information will happen. So first, it will get registered in the Pokédex, and then it will show you this entire menu. So it tells you a lot about the Pokémon. For example, its combat points. Then its name. You can also change its name. You I'm gonna call it Voltsanic, because it's based off something. It's a long explanation, but I'm not gonna explain it. Then it shows you the HP. You get more HP in a Pokemon from having higher level. Also, it tells you the type. Pikachu is electric. It tells you its weight, its height. It also tells you if it's extra large or extra small. There's a lot of info to be taken in. But the most important part of this is the Stardust and Pikachu candy. See, when you catch a Pokemon, it gives you three of that respective Pokemon's candy. And it also gives you Stardust. Stardust is very important. So Stardust is used for powering up Pokemon. And we have 100, but you use 200 and one Pikachu candy to power it up. And you also use Pikachu candy to evolve and power up, but you want to save the candies for evolving. And just a tip, you wanna save all your Stardust, because you don't want to waste it. Because when you have really powerful Pokemon and you want to power them up, and you've used all your Stardust, you're in a bad spot. Also, it tells you the attacks and the date that you caught it. You can also favorite it, which is, it does something special. So, transferring a Pokemon gives you one of its respective candy, but since it's a favorited Pokemon, you can't transfer it. It says, can't transfer a favorite Pokemon. So, it says, congratulations, you've caught your first Pokemon. I'm gonna let you sink that in. You're such a talented Pokemon trainer. What should I call you? And then, this is where we get to the naming spot. So, I'm gonna call myself... This is the most mind-boggling thing to choose. The name, it's like, it took me 1 hour sometimes. Put this goblin. No. Put this trainer. Yeah. Wow. It's not available. See, some people have names and you get what you get and you don't be upset. So maybe trainer of Buddhists. Yes. Hey! Oh, what a cool nickname. Nice to meet you. You will need more Pokeballs and other useful items during your exploration. You can find items at PokéStops. They're found at interesting places such as sculptures and monuments. From now on, you'll be off exploring all over the world. I hope you get out there and catch Pokemon and register them in your Pokédex. It's time to go. And I'd like to demonstrate PokéStops, but if you look around the map where I live, you can tell that there are no PokéStops anywhere, which is kind of sad. You also have your nearby list, which tells you the Pokémon that are nearby, which I was emphasizing this one because it's kind of good. But anyway, once you click this Pokéball at the bottom, it brings you up a menu. And you have four choices to choose from. Pokemon, it shows you your collection of Pokemon and your eggs. Your Pokedex, and it tells you what you've caught and what you've seen. There are 151 Pokemon in total, and you can see them in your Pokedex. And it's so satisfying when you collect all the Pokemon and you see them in your Pokedex. But I'm getting off topic. The Pokedex is basically like a collection or a dictionary, which is a better term, the dictionary of a Pokemon, maybe. When you catch a Pokemon or see a Pokemon or hatch a Pokemon, it's registered in your Pokédex. And when you click on that Pokemon in your Pokédex, it shows you what type it is, what number it is, how many you've seen and caught, what weight it is usually, what type it is, its description. I'll read this over quickly. Pikachu is the mouse Pokemon. Whenever Pikachu comes across something new, it blasts it with a jolt of electricity. If you come across a blackened berry, It's evidence that this Pokemon mistook the intensity of its charge. Evolution, it also shows you the evolution chart. Pikachu, when you get enough candies to evolve it, it evolves into a Raichu. But I wish I could show that in the future. So, moving on, we have shop next. In the shop, it gives you a whole broad spectrum of things to buy. Actually, all the items that are in the game currently, except for the upgraded ones. But you buy them using a currency called Pokécoins. And you get Pokécoins by using real money or from gyms. You get them from gyms by collecting them on daily rewards, or you can use money to buy them. And for $1, it's 100. It's probably a 1 cent to one Pokécoin conversion, and maybe even more in this case, like $100 to 145 ratio. But you can get a lot of useful stuff from the shop, and especially when you're in a time when you need a lot of Pokéballs, incense, lucky eggs, lure modules, or egg incubators. And I'll explain that when we get to the items section, bag upgrade, and Pokémon storage upgrade. Even though Niantic may not like me for this, Pokemon Go is usually a free-to-play game, so you don't have to spend a single dime to get where you want to be. But if you're really in a struggle, maybe you want to do it. However, I'm level 17, and I haven't spent a single dime, and I've got a lot of Pokemon. So maybe if it's really, really important, you could use your dollars, but I'm not gonna do that. Anyway, if we go to the item section, we get our showcase of items. We have four items currently. We have incense, which is a mysterious fragrance that lures wild Pokemon to your location for 30 minutes. I'm going to activate that right now. And then I'm going to explain the next ones. Pokeball. It's a device for catching wild Pokemon, which we've already seen. It's thrown like a ball at a Pokemon, comfortably encapsulating its target. It's funny because, you know, like, giant Pokemon can fit inside this one Pokeball. Next, you have your camera. When you encounter a Pokemon in your wild, you can use your camera to photograph them. And I'll show them once we encounter a Pokemon. Then you have your egg incubator, which I explained about it in the egg catching video guide. A device that incubates an egg as you walk until it's ready to hatch. It has unlimited uses because you're beginning your game. Oh, and a Pokemon just arrived at our doorstep, so let's click on it. And that's how you encounter it. A wild Goldeen appeared. And you can see that it has an unknown CP. And once we catch it, its CP will be revealed. You can also use different items during the battle, but I don't have other items to showcase. You can also use your camera during the battle. It also connects with your iPhone or Android's photo collection and puts it in there. So let's take a picture of this fish. And then you save it, or you can trash it if you don't like it. So, explain the mechanics of catching a Pokemon. To catch a Pokemon, you need to throw the Pokeball at the Pokemon, but there are many ways to do it. When you click on the Pokeball, you can see that there's a green circle that gets slowly smaller and smaller. See, if you, when it starts big, and you get it within the circle, it starts with nice. When it's medium-sized and you throw it at it, you get a great. If it's very small and you hit it on the right spot, you get an excellent. And these bonuses get you XP. So, I advise you to practice your Pokeball throwing if you want to get a higher level faster. But there's also a special feature where you can you can spin your finger in a circular motion, and it gets your Pokeball spinning, and you can throw it at an angle so that it curves basically and hits the Pokemon. And let's see if I can do this right on the first try. Oh, I did, but I kind of moved the iPad, but still fine. I got it. And now suspense, and now satisfaction. Gotcha. Goldeen was caught. It gives you 10 XP for a curveball, 10 XP for a nice ball, 50 or 20 XP for a great ball, and 100 for excellent ball. Pokemon caught, it gives you 100. A new Pokemon would give you 500. So your first catch with Pikachu plus this one would equal 610. So you have 1220 already. That's good. You also get your Stardust and your candy. It's registered to the Pokédex now. Now we can see its CP, but we didn't able to when it was in battle. And just to demonstrate, see here, Stardust, Golden Candy. We have enough Stardust to power up. Even though I told you not to do this early, this is a dummy account, so I have a lot of resources to waste. So let's click power up. Power up increases its CP, and you want to do that to gain advantages in gyms battles. Power up. Do you want to power up Goldeen? Since this is a dummy account, I'm going to press yes. Ah! It added 13 CP, and that's like double of what you would get in a battle. But normally, it would only add 10 to 15. It doesn't double the amount of CP it has. So don't get that misconception. Also has its moves, the day I caught it, and its weight. Also has extra small. And, level up. That's very good. So when you level up, you get item bonuses. And, these item bonuses are very good when you're in a very serious thing, and you need more Pokeballs. Well, when you level up, hey, more Pokeballs, yeah. When you first start, you need to get 1,000 XP to level up. But as you gain levels, it starts to add more. For the first 5 or 10 levels, it adds 1,000 to the max that you need to get. But when you get to above that, it adds more than just 1,000. This is also my profile. What the? This is also my profile, which you can see on the bottom left. It tells you your avatar, which is this, your name, how much XP you have, what level you are, how much Pokécoins you have, the start date, and your team. I'll explain more about team when we get to level 5. You also have badges. These do nothing in the game, but they're good for people who are completionists and want to be the best Pokemon master you can ever be. And I'm like those people. And there's no bonuses in getting these, but it's just so satisfying when it happens. So, a new Pokemon has just arrived. It disappeared. Oh no. Rest in peace. You will be missed. So when you're first starting off your game, you don't have to go to the beach necessarily to start off your Pokemon journey. You can always go to your item menu and use incense. And it gives you like a starting head start for 30 minutes to catch Pokemon. And I really want to catch this Pokemon because it's really semi-rare. Probably needless to say, to get to this point, you need to actually sign up. And I've explained that in one of my other videos. I've also explained about egg hatching and Pokégyms in other videos of mine. And you should check those videos out if you're a newbie to Pokémon Go or haven't gotten Pokémon Go to your country yet. This video was just to give you like a rough start on Pokemon Go. See, if Pokemon Go hasn't come to your country yet, and you watch this video, you already have a basic head start of how to play, and that also has its advantages. When you have a higher level, that has its privileges and prejudices. People will come to you for advice, too, so you'll gain some popularity, too. Oh, I also encountered a new Pokemon. You want to get higher level because games are about being the best. And if you're popular, what could be better than that? in my opinion. But let's catch this Pokemon anyway. And I'm gonna try to get a green. I guess that didn't go as far as I intended. Pew! My anticipation skills are not that good. What the heck? That's sad. That's funny. I'm trying so hard. It's just upstanding me. Yes! Great. See, it says you got great. I had a great-great once. My great-great-grandfather had a great-great too. Gotcha. Slowpoke was caught. Wait, what? It should give you a bonus XP for having a great throw, but apparently that doesn't show up. That's weird. Anyway, it's registered to the Pokédex, and you see all of it. I'm just going to end this off with reading the last two Pokédex entries. So we have Slowpoke. He's number 79. We've seen one and caught one. His type is Water and Physics. This Pokemon's type is the Dopey Pokemon. Slowpoke uses its tail to catch prey by dipping it in water at the side of a river. However, this Pokemon often forgets what it's doing and often spends entire days just loafing at water's edge. Also, just a trivia fact, Slowpoke tails are very rare. In the Pokemon world, they're worth like 999,999 Pokecoins, which, wow. But I guess there's something you eat. It's really weird too. And it evolves into Slowbro, but you can't see that because you haven't caught Slowbro yet. Also, the final one we'll read is Goldeen, 118, and he's a type water type. It's called the Goldfish Pokemon. Wow, thanks, Captain Obvious. Goldeen is a very beautiful Pokemon with fins that billow elegantly in water. However, don't let your guard down around this Pokemon. It could ram you powerfully with its horn. It says it's very beautiful, but if you look closer, you'll look at its eyes. Does that look like beautiful eyes? No, it doesn't. But anyway, it evolves into Sea King, but since you haven't caught Sea King, it doesn't show you that. So when you're at a higher level, you gotta really make tough decisions when you're at a strain with Pokeballs. Let's say, for example, you have only, like, 3 Pokeballs, maybe, and there are no PokéStops in sight. And a Caterpie just appeared on our screen. Let's see. See, Caterpie is usually not a very good Pokemon to get if you only have 3 Pokeballs, but it depends. If you see a Caterpie with a very high CP, with this Pokemon, probably about over 200 would be the best estimate, and you don't want it if it's lower than that. But this has a CP of 10, and see, if I'm like a higher level and I only have 3 Pokeballs, should I get this? It's not rare enough, so I'll press run away. Run away is this top left button, and it has that very, very detailed picture of a person running away. Boop! And see, when you run away, the Pokemon is not visible. Sometimes it doesn't do that, sometimes it does. But if you accidentally click run away, then there's no warning asking you if you really want to run away. So it's really sad if, like, there's a rare Pokemon. When you get higher in level, the Pokemon become harder to catch because when you throw a Pokeball, sometimes it will escape from the Pokeball. And you have to keep throwing Pokeballs in order to get the Pokemon caught. And that costs a lot of Pokeballs. But, in order to quell that fear of losing all them Pokeballs, you have an option when you go past, I think, level 5 or 10, you get these things called raspberries. You can feed, it's kind of hard to see because it's gray text, but you can use this, you can feed it to a Pokemon to make it easier to catch. And this is very helpful in battles, and if you use one of them, it could save you a lot of Pokéballs. So advice, always use that when you get it, okay? I'm Aiman, and thanks for watching. Please like, rate, comment, and subscribe, and look at other videos on EyeOnAiman, especially the Pokémon Go videos. Pokémon Master Aiman, signing out. Peace.